a magnificent piece of an airplane. It had everything that you need to go into to war with, to win. It was a lovely airplane. It was just like keeping the same girlfriend for many years. She's good looking, and you want to stay with her, I guess. I think I was speechless, really. What can you say? You know, you just look. And I was flabbergasted. It looked just gorgeous. It was the greatest thing I'd seen in a long time.
I just want to know more about his experience, because I don't know that much about my grandfather, because we rarely ever talk about his past or the war. It's more what's going on now in the future. He cares more about me and my future than me learning about his past.
I didn't think they were interested.
I would definitely like to sit down and pick his brain as much as I could, but he's a tough one. He won't let out too much information.
I'm not one to sit down, hey, come here, I want to tell you something, but, you know, I'll tell you a war story. I never did that.
The rebirth of February, I think, sparked an interest in his plane and what he went through in World War II in general. So it's brought us all closer together, and we talk about it more. He tells stories he's never told before, because we asked different, you know, questions.
Seeing my grandpa's name on it was, it definitely, it all became real.
You know, when you hear a story from my grandfather and all his buddies, it's different from what you see in the movies and what you have your history teachers say, because they weren't there and they don't know really what it was like. So it's different. There's two different sides. And it's good to hear their story over a history teacher's story.
When I see it, I can picture myself walking out to the Mustang and when I was in Italy. And you had a certain routine when you walked out before taking off, because you're going to be gone 5 to 6 hours. First, you have to go to the bathroom. What they call the nervous pee. And you walk around the airplane and you look at the thing and you look and you really are getting yourself psyched up to go. Because you don't know whether you're going to come back or not, so you're doing all these little things and you kind of have this brave smile. You're looking at the crew chief and he's looking at you. And when you crawl into the airplane, he crawls up on the wing with you. And he kind of messes around. But when you close the canopy, he's the last guy you see. It's a whole little world that you psych yourself into. And you stay that way until you get back. But to see the Mustang, that's going to be your home for the next 5 or 6 hours. You know? And it's going to either leave you up there is going to bring you back. When I see you in February, I think about all those things. It comes back very real.
Being in Ohio and attending the gathering of Mustangs and Legends was really the first time that we were in our grandfather's element. I'm sure it was very emotional for him seeing all those old guys that he was friends with and to see all the airplanes there. It had to have been a really, really powerful, emotional thing for him to experience.
I'm alive, that's about all I can say.
What they've done is big. And, you know, just to be around here and shake these guys' hands, it's quite an honor.
You're much too young to have been in World War II. How about that?
To know that, you know, that generation is coming to an end it's emotional and it's sad because he's part of it.
Well, we're getting old. It's happened. The World War II guys in the 80s. You see. So although it's hurts, but there it is. It's going to happen to us all.
the second I got in it and we took off, it was just the greatest experience of my life. Being up in the air, seeing the landscape down below, and hear the noise of it, feel its power, just an experience that I will never forget. To think that my grandpa was probably way younger than I was flying in that thing, and he was the pilot, and I was just a passenger. It just made it all the more worthwhile to be his granddaughter and to know what a fantastic guy that he really is.
For my grandfather to be up there, not really enjoying it because he had enemy aircraft firing at him, and he was escorting bombers up to Germany. It was a whole different experience for me compared to what my grandfather went through.
The fact that we were up there in such a chill, peaceful environment, thinking about Papa up there actually fighting in combat, it really puts things into perspective of what he went through.
When he had the cockpit open, we're taxiing on the runway, you could smell the exhaust. And to me, that was like, wow, my grandfather's telling me a story. I kind of know what it smells like now. I know what it sounds like. So it makes those stories come alive.
She likes going fast and going upside down.
Going fast and going upside down, definitely.
She's got a little bit of that Jim Brooks in her.
That was incredible.
Someday when I have my own kids and I'm telling them about their great-grandfather and my grandpa, I think that I would have nothing but really cool things to tell them.
Not that they walk around and talk World War II stories, but they feel a part of that now. I think they can appreciate a little bit more. All I can say, and I said before, it makes me sad. And I may be the last one standing. That's not saying too much because there's not too many of us left.